Good morning, PV. I'm Austin Morse.
And I'm Daniel Bridgegate.
Tomorrow is Blackout Day. Show your pride. Homecoming is one of those memories you'll actually remember in the years to come. Don't miss out. Purchase your tickets for $35. Stugo promises you won't regret the investment.
Also, tomorrow is the big day. It's the homecoming football game. Before the game, Stugo is hosting a tailgate starting at 4:30 in the mall area. So come out, get pumped for the game, and enjoy food, games, and fun for only $4.
Freshmen had their last football game. They didn't win, but showed great effort.
The game here at PV just ended. I'm here with Emily Ginsburg and Donnie McKissick, part of the cheer squad and one of our high school students. What were your thoughts on the game?
Our Trojans did so good tonight. Even though we didn't win, we had a great last game and we're just so proud of them. Great job, guys.
Season was good and we can do better next year when they join.
Can I get a PV pride?
Woo! Go Trojans! Thanks.
Call is tonight at 7 o'clock. If you haven't bought your ticket yet, buy yours from one of the Powder Puff players or buy yours at lunch today.
Do you want your own photos to be featured in the yearbook? The PVHS yearbook staff wants you to upload your pictures to replayit.com or to the Replayit app. Replayit is a free program that allows students and teachers to upload their own photos for use in the yearbook. We'll even give you photo credits if we use your photo. Make sure to upload all pictures related to homecoming, including Spirit Days, the football game, the dance, and more.
Hey girls, the days continue to tick down. Only 11 days until your Trojan soccer season begins. Get those physicals completed, turn in your paperwork, and see Coach Chu in room 209 if you have any questions.
There will be a boys basketball informational meeting on Wednesday, October 29th at 2:15 p.m. in the gym lobby classroom. If you're interested in trying varsity, junior varsity, or freshman, varsity tryouts will start on Monday, November 3rd. If you have any questions, please contact Coach McGowan.
What about Victor's selfie contest? Want to know who the winners were? Here you go.
Thank you so much to Sharon and Jamie for contributing in Power My Contest during first lunch. The winner of the contest during first lunch is Jamie. Congratulations to Jamie.
I know the ball I keep and the dribble overhead. But the truckers hitch.
Took selfies with 19 people in total, while Sharon took pictures with 17 people. Jamie, you'll get your prize soon. Thank you once again.
We're competing to see how many Goodwill donations PBHS can come up with by Friday. Bring your goods and drop them off in front of the West parking lots. We're counting on you.
After the bell will be canceled on Monday, October 27th, due to staff meeting, and the Trojan Corner will also be closed today.
If you're interested in politics or history and you are a junior or senior, then Paradise Valley High School provides you with the opportunity of a lifetime to travel to Washington, D.C. on our school's annual close-up trip. This educational trip takes place from Sunday, March 15th, 2015 through Friday, March 20th, 2015. You will participate in mock congresses and also have the opportunity to tour historic sites and discuss current political issues at places like the Lincoln Memorial, the Smithsonian, and the Vietnam Memorial. There will be very short informational meetings after school this coming Thursday at 2:15. For any junior or senior interested in going. This trip is not just an AP trip and is open to any and all juniors and seniors. The meeting will take place in Mr. Max's room 213 and will be done by 2:30. See you there.
Well, that sounds like a lot of fun. There's a festival this weekend where the entire Paradise Valley community comes together. All PVHS clubs are invited to sponsor a booth at the event.
And all PVHS students are also invited to attend and bring their little brothers and sisters. Bring your parents for a fun time. However, parents should not be left unattended.
For more information on sponsoring a booth, contact Holly Gorman in room 126 or any JAG student. Otherwise, hope to see you there.
Have you been into any haunted house lately?
No, I hate those places.
I have. They're awesome. Here's a look at Fear Farm.
gosh.
Why won't you help me?
How safe is this haunted house? Our reporter Luis had a chance to talk to Fire Chief Brian about it.
Halloween around the corner. Do you have any tips on which haunted houses our students should go to?
Yeah, there's only 3 approved haunted houses in the city of Phoenix, and they're on our website, phoenix.gov/fire. And the reason they're approved is we actually have been through them and made sure they were safe. There are certain safety features that are required in a haunted house. Big one is a fire alarm. So if there's a fire that goes on, the fire alarm will come on, and then all the theatrical devices will shut down, and the characters will become rescuers and help you get out of the building. Other is a fire sprinkler system. So if there is a fire, sprinklers will come on and actually control that fire. A big one for us, and that's kind of the one that we don't see most often in the unapproved haunted houses, is exiting. Most of the time in an unapproved haunted house, you have the way you got in, and you have to go through all the entire maze so you can get out to the end. In an approved haunted house, you won't see them, but there's exits throughout the entire maze. So any 20 feet you go, give or take, there actually is an exit. We'll get you in an exit corridor and out of the building. The last thing, everything's got to be fire retardant or fireproof. So if there is a small fire, that it's not just going to race across the floor on hay or any kind of decoration. So that's a big thing for us. So we're telling people right now, go to the 3 haunted houses that are approved because we know that those are safe.
Did you know that the 13th floor is one of only a few haunted houses that have been approved by the city's fire department?
Didn't know.
It's pretty cool, actually. Here's Brian to tell you why it is important that you know a haunted house is safe before you enter.